Hello, my students. Today is Friday and we are so happy to be here, Teacher Yosira.
Yes, as Teacher Evelyn said, we are so happy to be here this Friday with you, each Friday, sharing with you important things that are going to help you to improve your English language communication. Okay, so we're very glad to have you here. Remember that we got several ways that you can join our classes and you can share with us. We got Instagram, we got Facebook, we got WhatsApp, so you can join the classes, you can interact, you can ask questions, practices, and everything. We got a special guest today, Teacher Evelyn.
Yes, that's right. And it's psychologist Osiris Moreno.
Thank you very much, teachers. Buenas tardes, queridos estudiantes. Soy la psicóloga Osiris Moreno y estoy muy contenta de poder compartir con ustedes un breve momento con la cápsula Un Minuto para Ti. ¿Qué son las emociones? Las emociones son un sistema de alarma que nos informan cómo nos encontramos y qué es lo que pasa a nuestro alrededor. Conocer cuáles son nuestras emociones nos ayudan a generar cambios en nuestra vida, mejorar la comunicación y entender lo que pasa con nosotros mismos y con los demás. Una lista de las emociones que más experimentamos son el enojo o la ira, el miedo, la tristeza, la felicidad, el amor. Las emociones van y vienen. Algunas emociones duran tan solo segundos y otras un poco más. Por ejemplo, cuando el chico llega de la escuela y resulta que no le guardaron postres. Entonces se enoja, manotea, grita, patalea, se enoja terriblemente. Las emociones pueden ser leves, intensas o medias. Esto depende de la situación y la persona. Como el chico del postre, ¿verdad? La de él fue intensa. Fue corta, pero intensa. Se exaltó mucho. Y no pensó en lo importante que podría ser para los demás. Pero él puede en algún momento pensar, voy a calmarme, yo sé que para la próxima me toca más. No existen buenas o malas emociones, pero sí buenas y malas formas de expresarlas o actuarlas. Vimos cómo uno de ellos, de estos muchachos, se expresó de mala manera, con gritos, rabia y pataleta. El otro fue lo opuesto, fue muy calmado. Él sintió asombro de que no le dejaran postre, pero no actuó agresivamente. Tratar de fingir que no sentimos puede tener consecuencias negativas en nuestra salud emocional. Hay que aprender a reconocerlas y respetar nuestras emociones. Todas las emociones vividas, hay que saber, son normales. Nos dicen algo de nosotros mismos. Nos dicen que después de haber sido grosero por actuar de mala manera, eso nos hizo sentir culpables, por lo cual la próxima vez lo recordaré y es probable que no repita mi conducta por ese sentimiento de culpabilidad que no me gustó. Entonces, jóvenes, en otras cápsulas les vamos a estar brindando más tips y recomendaciones y le vamos a estar informando sobre este mundo maravilloso que son las emociones. Y recuerda, ¿cómo te sientes hoy? Si en algún momento necesitas ayuda, tenemos nuestras líneas de apoyo telefónico. Algunas de ellas son en Chiriquí 774-4428, en Panamá Oeste, 515-7396, Bocas del Toro, 758-5377. Muchísimas gracias y adelante.
Thank you very much. Teacher Evelyn, before you start with the lesson, we got special greetings here to people who are joining the class, Xiomara Serrano, Melissa, Luisa Maca, Yari, Gregorio Aguilar, people who are joining the class, thumb up. Thank you very much. Thank you. Remember that you can interact with us. You can send your responses. Also, you can ask questions and send your greetings. Teacher Evelyn.
Yes. Okay, let's begin. And now we are going to do a tongue twister. Tongue twister, trabalenguas, okay?
Yes.
Now, Professor Yosira and Psychology Yosira is going to do it with me. Okay, you have to repeat three times. Red lorry, yellow lorry. I'm going to repeat again. Red lorry, yellow lorry. Okay, now we have to do it faster, okay? Do it faster. Three times, okay? One, two, three.
Red lorry, yellow lorry. Red lorry, yellow lorry. Red lorry, yellow lorry.
Very good. Okay, excellent. What is a tongue twister? Well, what tongue twister is used to practice and improve pronunciations? It's the way that we can practice words in English, okay? So you can find a lot of tongue twister through Google. So it's time to practice. Now, the topic for today is introducing yourself and others. Introducing yourself and others. ¿Cómo te puedes, cómo te presentas? Y cómo presentas a otras personas. Learning objective. You will be able to introduce yourself and others. And also you will be able to create formal text using appropriate grammar and vocabulary. Now let's review some vocabulary so far. What's your name?
What's your name?
My name is.
My name is.
You can call me.
You can call me.
Nickname.
Nickname.
Hello.
Hello.
Hi.
Hi.
At.
At.
My.
My.
Okay, very good. Now, there are some phrases that you can use when you are going to introduce yourself. In this case, you need to, the first one that you need to do is you have to say your name, decir tu nombre. And there are some phrases that can help you, que te pueden ayudar. My name is, and you can say your name. My name is Evelyn Miranda. I'm Evelyn Miranda is another example. When someone introduces you, cuando alguien te presenta, you can say, nice to meet you. I'm Evelyn Miranda. Pleased to meet you. I'm Evelyn Miranda. Let me introduce myself. Déjame presentarme. Let me introduce myself. I'm Evelyn Miranda. I would like to introduce myself. Me gustaría presentarme. I would like to introduce myself. I'm Evelyn Miranda. This is the first thing you have to do. You have to say your name. Okay, so there are some phrases that you can use. Now, when you want to talk about you, cuando vas a hablar de ti, it's very important to say some important things. For example, you can say the first one, the name. Also, where do you come from? De dónde vienes? What do you like to eat? What do you like? What is your favorite color? Or what? Or how old are you? Okay? ¿Cómo te llamas? Tu color favorito, comida favorita, cuántos años tienes? There are important questions so the people can know you. Así las personas te pueden conocer a little better. Okay? Now, from you guys through WhatsApp, you just shout us, give us your name, give us some type of favorite food, your favorite color. Ahora ustedes nos van a escribir, a chatear, okay? Sus nombres, qué les gusta, qué edad tienen. Okay, my name is, I come from, I live in, I am years old, I have a, you can also say it if you have a sister or if you have brothers, okay? My favorite food is, I also like to eat, también me gusta comer. I don't like, que no me gusta, I don't like. I never eat, que nunca como, okay? My favorite drink, what do you like to drink? ¿Qué te gusta tomar? So there are some answers so other people can know you. Son respuestas que las personas te pueden conocer. Yes, teacher Yesira?
Well, we have here people joining the class. Silvia, Ila, Anita, Jose MV, Dadris, Melquisede. It's 7th grade, sorry, 10th grade, 10th grade,
right.
Yeah, it says 1st grade here, that's why I got confused, it's 10th grade, décimo grado, okay, so people are joining, remember, you can send your responses here, okay, and we're gonna read it, okay?
Yes, tell us something about you.
Saludos a Vanis y a Victoria, hello, okay?
Yes.
Good evening, teachers. Saludo para los niños del Centro de Educación Potrero de Caña, en especial para Astrid, Ladies, Marcus, en sintonía. La educación no tiene límites. Bendiciones, teachers.
Amen.
People sending
Thank
responses
you.
Here say, hi, my name is Luisiana. Hi, my name is Dayana. Hello.
Very good.
Very
Excellent.
Good.
Okay, now, to continue, how to introduce others, it will be like this. Cuando introduces a alguien, okay, you can say, puedes decir, there are some phrases, algunas frases. For example, Jack, please meet Nicholas. Jack, please meet Nicholas, okay? If you are talking to another one, cuando estás hablando con alguien y introduces a otra, a una tercera persona, you will say some phrases, algunas frases como esta. Jack, please meet Nicholas. Jack, have you met Nicholas? I would like you to meet Lisa. I would like to introduce you to Betty. Leila, this is Barbara. Barbara, this is Leila. So there are some kind of expressions that you can use. Yes?
A lot of people are responding here. Livia, my name is Livia. I come from Italy. I live in Don Bosco. Whoa. Great. Hello, teacher. My name is Micaela. My name is Juan David. People are responding and sending their names. My name is Gabriel Arias. My name is Luis. Hello
Very
to
good.
Everybody.
Hello, hello. Okay. Now, what happened when you want to introduce a friend that have something in common? It will be very easy for you guys. En esta ocasión es más fácil introducir a una persona si todos tienen algo en común. Things in common. And there are some examples that you can use. Son ejemplos. For example, she is my friend Amy and she also likes strawberries. Ella es mi amiga Amy y a ella también le gustan las fresas. Siempre y cuando los amigos que tengas con la persona que vayas a introducir tengan las mismas cosas en común. Another example. She is my friend Josita and she also likes to read comics.
That's true.
He is my friend Harold and he also takes soccer lessons. And the last example we have here. He is my friend Ian and he also plays video games. There are some examples that you can use when you have something in common with your friends and the friends that you want to introduce to the group. Okay? Do you have some greetings?
Yes, teacher. Yes? Mm-hmm. Buenas tardes, profe. Le saluda la estudiante Isabel de Montezuma, de la comarca Colegio Boca de Macho.
Ay.
Hello, hello.
Saludos para todos los estudiantes de cada colegio. Saludo para Didia Montezuma, de que está conectada con las estrellas.
Wow, excellent. Great. A lot of people responding here. My name is Renee. People saying their names. My name is Yesenia. She is my friend Diana and also likes. We don't know really what she likes really. I don't understand the part there. But it says my friend is Diana.
Okay. Very, very good. That's right. Remember that you can share with us your answers. Compartir con nosotros sus respuestas, okay? There are practice things in common. Things in common that you have with your friends and the friends that you want to introduce to the group. Now, what happened if, ¿qué pasa si? What happened if you couldn't hear very clearly the name? ¿Qué pasa si no escuchaste bien el nombre de la persona que te presentaron? What happened? Well, there are some phrases that you can use or expressions that you can use. For example, I'm sorry, what was your name again? Don't worry, my name is Amy. I'm going to repeat again, lo voy a volver a repetir. I'm sorry, what was your name again? Estás haciendo la pregunta que ¿cuál es tu nombre otra vez? What was your name again? Y la persona respondería, don't worry, my name is Amy. Another example, sorry, I couldn't hear your name very well. Can you repeat it for me, please? And the person is going to reply to you, sure, no problem. My name is Amy. I'm going to repeat. Sorry, I couldn't hear your name very well. Can you repeat it for me, please? Sure, no problem. My name is Amy. Okay, very good.
We don't want to miss people who are saying here, she's my friend Louisiana, and she also likes apples. She's my friend, he's my friend Juan, and he also likes music. You have to add the S to the like part, to the verb like. Hay que agregarle la S cuando hablamos en tercera persona, debemos agregarle la S al verbo. That is for Gabriel SSJ. We're here to learn, but we're very happy that you are responding. Estamos muy felices de sus respuestas.
That's right, very good. And remember, when we're talking about introducing someone, right, we're talking about simple present, en presente, simple present, okay? And we use the pronouns she, he, okay, if singular, plural, they, we, you, okay? And the verb to be is am, or, and it depends on the pronoun, okay? Very good. Now, you have an assignment for today. And we are going to upload that through our Google Classroom, right? And you have to introduce to someone. You have to introduce someone. You have to tell us the name and where she lives, how old she or he has, right? His brother or he has sister. Yes, teacher?
We got Yadel Ortiz. Hello, my sister's name is Jared and my brother Ronaldo. I like to eat everything. Okay, great. She's my friend Gabriel and he also likes cakes. Okay, I like cake too.
Very good.
Thank you. Your responses are great. You're doing a great job. Okay.
Saludos para los chicos de octavo y noveno grado de la escuela de Cerro Plata.
Hello to them. Very good. Now, remember that the assignment is that you have to introduce to, it will be a family member, right? Or a friend. You have to tell us the name, what's his or her favorite food, what country would like to visit, right? And, okay, remember that we use simple present. And let's back to the practice, all about you. All about you, acerca de ti. Remember that you can chat us through us, your name, where do you live, how old are you, tell us what do you like, what do you dislike, and also tell us if you have sister, if you have brother, you can tell us the name, okay? This is very important because the
Yes, go ahead. Because she is my friend Stephanie, and she also likes, remember to add the IS to the verb. Tenemos que agregarle cuando estamos hablando de otra persona en singular, le agregamos la S al verbo. So she also likes. She is my friend Stephanie. She is my friend Stephanie, not another is, okay? My friend Angelica. I like ice cream. Great. Okay. A lot of people responding here. We want to send greetings to Yarinet, Alan, Jair Castillo, who are joining the class. Remember that you can participate. You can say, where do you come from? Where do you live? Okay. You can respond to those questions. Very good.
Okay. Excellent. You did an excellent job today, guys. And remember, don't move because the next class that you're going to hear is 11th grade. So please don't move and we just come back, okay? Bye-bye.
Take care. Take care. We will wait for you here.
Con la visión de fortalecer la participación de los padres de familia y los integrantes de la comunidad educativa, escolar y regional, el Ministerio de Educación, en alianza con las emisoras comprometidos con la formación de todos los estudiantes a nivel nacional, ha creado el proyecto educativo Conéctate con la Estrella.
Hoy vamos a hablar de la comunicación para sexto grado.
Los números naturales son aquellos que nos permiten contar los elementos de un conjunto.
Donde miles de niños y jóvenes se beneficiarán con las clases dictadas por profesores a través de la radio para estudiantes de primaria, premedia y media. Una alternativa educativa para los estudiantes que se encuentran en casa respetando la cuarentena por la pandemia del COVID-19. De esta manera, Meduca y estas emisoras garantizan que la educación no pare y que los estudiantes panameños no afecten su proceso de aprendizaje llevando a los maestros hasta su hogar. Gracias a Los 40 Principales, Radio Panamá, Más Música, Radio Mía, RPC Radio, Telemetro Radio, Osana Capital, TVN Radio, Nacional, Crisol, Radio Hogar y Radio Católica. Síguenos en @NacionalFMPanamá y @CrisolFMPanamá. Conecte con la educación, entretenimiento e información. Con dos estaciones de radio unidas con la comunidad. Juntos lo hacemos. Hoy más que nunca necesitamos estar unidos y bien informados.
Este es un equipo y el equipo se llama Panamá.
El futuro del país está en la educación de nuestros jóvenes. El Ministerio de Educación ha lanzado diferentes proyectos educativos para que los estudiantes, profesores y padres de familia puedan acceder a estos recursos y sigan aprendiendo desde casa como Ayudinga, Portal Educativo Educa Panamá, clases virtuales, foros educativos, capacitaciones para docentes, módulos didácticos, Leemos un cuento y más de 300 cursos virtuales. Estas y otras iniciativas que impacten al país estaremos informando por Ser TV.
Conéctate con la Estrella, es
having our class today for 11th graders who are very glad to be here with you. Every Friday, helping you to improve your English language. Teacher Evelyn, you want to say something?
Yes, that's right. Hello, hello, everybody. Today is Friday, right? And remember that you can go to our Google Classroom, right? And the password is J-I-H-R-Z-G-W, J-I-H-R-Z-G-W. And also, you can chat us through WhatsApp at 6004-8182. Al 6004-8182, teacher.
Yes, and as we said, we got a special guest today, Ms. Osiris Moreno. She's a psychologist, and she's going to share with us something very important that we have to take in consideration during this time that we are going through difficult situations with the pandemic. So it's better to listen to some words that can help us to stay calm, to stay cool, okay? So, Ms. Moreno.
Thank you very much, teacher Josira. Buenas tardes, queridos estudiantes. Soy la psicóloga Osiris Moreno y estoy muy contenta de poder compartir con ustedes un breve momento con la cápsula Un Minuto para Ti. ¿Cómo está mi salud mental en esta pandemia? La salud mental es un estado de bienestar a nivel emocional, psicológico y social. La salud mental depende en nuestros pensamientos, nuestros sentimientos y nuestra conducta. Si no te sientes bien, esto interfiere en tu rendimiento escolar, tu trabajo o en tus relaciones interpersonales. Quizás nos estemos sintiendo incomprendidos, no entendamos una materia, que no podamos compartir personalmente con nuestros amigos. La pandemia del COVID-19 ha venido a ser parte de esas situaciones difíciles de entender. Ante esto, lo más importante es primero entender que somos seres humanos, que pasamos por diferentes situaciones y que lo más importante es buscar lo positivo de la situación que nos aflige. Cambios en el sueño, en la alimentación. Me puedo sentir ansiosa, triste, con rabia, desesperanza, la mayor parte del tiempo. Si presentas algunos de estos síntomas u otros que antes no te pasaban, busca ayuda en tus padres, un psicólogo de la escuela, una orientadora que pueda escucharte y ayudarte para enfrentar tus dificultades en estos tiempos de pandemia. Es normal que te sientas así, frente a una crisis mundial como la que estamos viviendo. Recuerda, no estás solo. Y para ayudarte tenemos la línea de apoyo emocional en diversas regiones del país. En Coclé, 997-8937, en Herrera, 996-6256, Panamá Centro, 511-4401. Thank you very much, Professor.
Thank you.
Thank you, Ms. Moreno, for these tips, and thank you for being here sharing this information with us. Okay, we're going to start. Teacher Evelyn, you want to say something, some greetings, who is joining the class?
Yes, Angela Amador Contreras. Good afternoon, teacher. Centro hello. Educativo Boca de Balsa from 11th grade. Hello, hello. Lorenzo Daniela.
Hello, hello, hello to everybody. Thank you for joining the class. Remember that you can chat us and you can send your responses, interact with us, sharing information also. Okay, the topic for today for 11th grade, undécimo grado, personality traits and professional background of famous people, okay? This is the topic for today. And what is the objective of this class? At the end of this class, you are going to be able to express ideas that describe emotions and feelings toward others. Also, to give information about professional background of famous people. Okay? Let's continue. And we got with the vocabulary here. We got some words. And I'm going to stop here. Voy a parar aquí. Voy a explicar algo. Remember, when the words that we're given, las palabras que estamos dando, I'm going to give you some words that are similar or have similar meaning, so you have an idea of what they mean, okay? De lo que ellos significan, de lo que estas palabras significan, okay? We're gonna start with the first word. Teacher Evelyn is going to help me with the pronunciation. Number one, skills.
skills.
It's about abilities. Number two, good at.
Good at.
It's about something that you got an special gift, okay? Something that you are good doing, okay? Something that you can do easily, okay? Number three, don't mind.
Don't mind.
So you don't care. It's not really important, okay? Number four, enjoy.
Enjoy.
It's talking about something that you like, you love, okay? That is, give you a positive vibe, okay? Love.
Love.
No explanation. You know what love is, okay? Hate.
Hate.
It's the opposite of love, okay? Negative feeling, okay? Hate. Can't stand.
Can't stand.
So, for example, if you are in a place that you can't stand the noise and everything, okay? Not something that is not comfortable for you, okay? So, let's continue. We got other words here. Teacher Evelyn is going to continue helping me with the pronunciation. We got reliable.
Reliable.
Reliable person. These are adjectives that we can use to describe people, okay? Nos ayudan a describir personas. We got reliable. It's about trusting a person that for you, it's that you can feel confident with that person. Number two, outgoing.
Outgoing.
Outgoing person is a person who likes to share, to talk, you know, to express his or her ideas. Number three, honest.
Honest.
Honest have to be with reliable, with trusting, confident, an honest person. Number four, hardworking.
Hardworking.
Hardworking person is a person who is always struggling, you know, to get his or her goals, okay? Hard working, likes to work very hard, okay? Number five, easygoing.
Easygoing.
It's a person who's very nice, very cool. You can talk with that person because it's the way that the person reacts is really nice, okay? Remarkable.
Remarkable.
Has to be with outstanding, okay? A person that is, for example, the most intelligent of the class or something, okay? Or the person has a special gift, okay? Something to give, something very important, okay? So, last one, creative.
Creative.
A creative person, you know, the person likes to build, to construct different things, okay? Innovating, we can say, innovating. Teacher Evelyn.
Yes, I want to say some greetings to Luisa, Cray Judith, Samir, It's Kelly, X Luis. Hello, hello.
Hello. Well, we continue here. What is personality trait? Okay, personality traits reflect people's characteristic. Okay, las características de las personas. Patterns of thoughts, patrones de pensamiento, feelings, sentimientos, behaviors, comportamiento. We got some examples here. He seems to be an honest man. Okay? We're using personality trait. As far as I know, he is reliable. Remember, reliable is about trusting. Okay? It's a confident. I love thinking about our future. Love showing feelings. Okay? Let's continue, and we got a practice here, and it says, describe the people in the pictures. We got two people here who are, who seems to be working, okay? And it says, what kind of person is he? And what kind of person is she? We got four words to describe people. We got remarkable, we got reliable, we got hardworking, we got creative. But we're going to change a little bit this practice. Vamos a cambiar un poco esta práctica. And I'm going to ask you about the person who is next to you. Vamos a ver a la persona que está cerca de ti, around you, okay? You can say, for example, me here in this moment, I can say, Teacher Evelyn is a hardworking person, okay? Teacher Evelyn is a hardworking person. Also, Miss Murillo, who is here, the psychologist, I can say she's a remarkable woman or a remarkable person. So you can say the same thing about people who are around you. Puedes utilizar estos adjetivos para expresar, no los puedes escribir, okay? Para expresar sobre aquella persona que está cerca de ti, okay? We're gonna wait for your responses here. We're going to continue, but you can shout us. pueden irnos chateando. Teacher Evelyn, I don't know if you have something to send or to...
Okay, greetings to J. Carlos, King, JM, Analysis, also hello.
Hello. Mm-hmm. Remember, use this adjective to describe someone that is close to you. Utilizan esto para poder describir a alguien que está cerca de ustedes.
No, son saludos.
That's just
the word. Aquí algunas personas.
Okay, remember that you can send your answers through Instagram, okay?
Very good. Okay. We're going to continue with another practice here. And we got two famous people from Panama, Mariano Rivera and Roberto Duran. We know what they are good at. Okay. So we're going to use these two. Enjoy. Remember, enjoy is something that you like. You love to do. Okay. You like. It gives you a positive vibe. Okay. Number two, good at expressing abilities, okay? And we got two sentences. Tenemos dos oraciones, and you have to complete those sentences with one of those words, okay? Enjoys or good at. Number one, we're talking about Mariano Rivera. He is enjoy playing baseball, or he is good at playing baseball. What do you think it is? Okay, you can chat. Okay, or teacher Evelyn is gonna help me here with the responses. Okay, he is enjoy playing baseball, or he is good at playing baseball. What do you think?
I will say letter B, good at.
He is good at playing baseball. Number two, we're talking about our famous boxer,
Roberto Duran,
and it says he enjoys boxing, or he good at boxing. Which one it is? Teacher Evelyn, you can say.
Okay, I will say A. He enjoys boxing.
He enjoys boxing. And in this case, we're adding the S. Estamos agregando la S a enjoy, because we are talking the in third person or singular. We're using third person of singular, he. So we have to pluralize the verb. Okay, teacher Evelyn.
Yes, I have here an answer. Ronay Samuel. He is good at playing baseball.
Great.
Very good. And also I have here Samir. But I think it's from the answer that he wrote is for 10th grade. My name is Marvin Samir. My brothers are called Yosin and Gadiel. Very good.
Thank you.
Greetings to M. Elipo, and also Ronai, he wrote, he enjoys boxing. Very good.
Yeah, he enjoys boxing. Great. Thank you very much for your responses. And let's go with the grammar part, and we got time clauses. Time clauses in the past, okay? Time clauses are used in English to demonstrate a period of time based on an action or event, similar to dependent clauses in conditional sentences. So these are words that are used to join sentences, okay? What are those? We got when, cuando, after, después, as soon as, tan pronto como, while, mientras. We got examples here. When I finish my lunch, we play golf. Cuando termine de mi almuerzo, jugaremos golf. After we play golf, we went to a party. Después de jugar golf, iremos a la fiesta, okay? And as soon as we arrive at the party, they put the sticks on. Tan pronto llegamos a la fiesta, comimos.
Yes, I'm sorry, teacher, I have a response back here. King, he grow, he's good at playing baseball. Very good.
Great.
And X Elizabeth, he enjoys boxing. Very good. And Markelo, ¿por dónde se envía la respuesta? You can send the answers through our platform's Google Classroom. Puedes hacerlo a través de Google Classroom.
Great. Okay, as I was saying, we're talking about time clauses. When, cuando, after, después, as soon as, tan pronto como, while, mientras. Okay? And we're going to check a little bit another expression to talk about past activities. Used to and didn't used to. Solía, no solía. Okay, talking about activity that you used to do in the past, but you are not right now, pero no la haces ahora mismo. Okay, we got two examples here. We used to go to France for our holidays when I was a child. Solíamos viajar a Francia para los días festivos cuando era niño. He didn't used to do any exercise as a child, but now he runs marathons. Él no solía hacer ejercicios de niño, pero ahora corre en maratones, okay? So, these are activities that in the past, okay? Talking about the past, okay? Used to, solía, didn't used to, no solía, ahora. You can see that when we say didn't used to, le quitamos el AD al verbo because didn't express the past tense. Yeah, didn't expresa la forma pasada. Okay, so let's continue with the last practice. Okay, we got two options to complete the sentences. Teacher Evelyn is going to help me with the responses. Okay, number one, Mariano Rivera play for the Yankees baseball team. So, talking about the past, Mariano Rivera used to, or Mariano Rivera didn't used to. What do you think it is, Teacher Evelyn?
A, used to.
Used to. Mariano Rivera used to play for the Yankees baseball team. Number two, Ruben Blades studied law when or after he was young, Teacher Evelyn.
A, when?
Well, in this case, Ruben Blades studied law when he was young. Very good. Number three, Roberto Duran ended his career when or after his professional record of 119 fights.
B.
B. Yes, Roberto Duran ended his career after his professional record of 119 fights. Excellent. Those are the responses there. Okay, Teacher Evelyn.
Just to say greeting to Maria Alberto, Jose Iglesias. Good afternoon.
Good afternoon. Thank you very much. We got the assignment for this class, okay? And you can describe a person from your family, give information of his or her personality, choose a famous person, and write about his or her professional background. And remember that you can upload your assignment to the Google Classroom platform so we can check your responses and give you some feedback, okay, in order for you to improve your English language. I don't know if there are another reading. No, we are running out of time.
Yes,
so,
all right.
Yes, we will continue with 12th grade.
Yes, don't move, please. Remember, 12th grade, okay? Bye, see you.
Saludos, soy el profesor Armando Rudas. Laboro en el Colegio Manuel María Tejada Roca de las Tablas, en la Cátedra de Religión, Ética y Valores. Y en esta cápsula, Momentos de Esperanza a través de Conéctate a la Estrella, estamos llevándole a ustedes temas en torno a religión, ética y valores. En el día de hoy vamos a hablar un poquito sobre los valores, un poquito sobre la introducción, si se quiere, de dónde vienen. La gente de fe, los que tenemos fe en Dios, creemos realmente que los valores son hijos de Dios, vienen de Dios. Y el hombre creado por Dios, por consiguiente, está llamado a vivir esos valores, los cuales deben ser puestos en práctica en la comunidad, entre nosotros. Lamentablemente, en medio de la pandemia, nos hemos dado cuenta que ha salido a resaltar la gran falta que hay de valores en Panamá, entre nosotros, en la sociedad, a nivel mundial. Por consiguiente, hay que trabajar mucho más en ellos. Bien, esperamos pues que poco a poco nosotros vayamos retomando el camino a través de la puesta en práctica de los valores que son elementos básicos para vivir la dignidad humana propia y respetar la de los demás. Continuaremos con este tema. Que pasen muy bien.
Hoy más que nunca necesitamos estar unidos y bien informados.
Esto es un equipo y el equipo se llama Panamá.
El futuro del país está en la educación de nuestros jóvenes. El Ministerio de Educación ha lanzado diferentes proyectos educativos para que los estudiantes, profesores y padres de familia puedan acceder a estos recursos y sigan aprendiendo desde casa como Ayudinga, Portal Educativo Educa Panamá, clases virtuales, foros educativos, capacitaciones para docentes, módulos didácticos, Leemos un cuento y más de 300 cursos virtuales. Estas y otras iniciativas que impacten al país estaremos informando por CERTV. El proyecto del Ministerio de Educación, Conéctate con la Estrella, también está en la radio. De lunes a viernes de 11 de la mañana a 12 mediodía es el turno de los chicos de primaria. Sintoniza Nacional AM y FM y Crisol. Prepárate para aprender y no quedarte sin saber, porque a las 2 de la tarde se vuelven a activar para los de premedia y a las 3 para los de media. Ya lo sabes, si eres de primaria, premedia o media, esto es para ti. Conéctate con la Estrella, un proyecto de Meduca, ahora en la radio, por Nacional AM y FM, Crisol, y por nuestras redes Instagram Live, arroba Nacional FM Panamá, arroba Crisol FM Panamá, Facebook Live, Nacional FM Panamá, Crisol FM Panamá, y Twitter, arroba Nacional FM y Crisol FM.
Hello back. Let's start with 12th graders. But before we start with the topic, we're going to listen to Ms. Osiris Moreno. She's a psychologist and she's going to give you an important message for these difficult times that we're going through.
Muchas gracias, teacher. Buenas tardes, queridos estudiantes. Soy la psicóloga Osiris Moreno y estoy muy contenta de poder compartir con ustedes un breve momento con la cápsula Un Minuto para Ti. Emociones y sentimientos. La emoción es definida por la neurociencia como una respuesta orgánica que crea reacciones bioquímicas en el cuerpo, alterando el estado físico actual. Los sentimientos son asociaciones mentales y reacciones hacia las emociones, según nuestras experiencias personales. Por ejemplo, una emoción. Cuando estás enamorado o enamorada, te sientes con una energía inigualable. Estás en estado de alerta. A todas horas estás pensando en el siguiente encuentro con esa persona. Sientes las famosas mariposas en el estómago, náuseas, ganas de desmayarte, entre otras situaciones físicas asociadas al enamoramiento. Sin embargo, después de un tiempo de relación con esa persona, incluso pueden pasar años, ya no se sienten esos altibajos emocionales y vuelves a estabilizarte. Sentimientos. Cuando los padres nos piden hacer algo y reaccionamos en ese momento de manera irritable y enfadada, por lo que la ira o rabia se apodera de nosotros, les hablamos mal, somos groseros con ellos. Después, cuando estamos más tranquilos y podemos pensar y actuar de manera menos impulsiva, nos damos cuenta de que exageramos y que no debimos de haber contestado así. Nos quedamos pensando en nuestra forma de actuar y se genera en nosotros un sentimiento de culpa a raíz del objetivo del análisis de lo que hicimos. Es decir, que ya no fue algo que comenzamos a sentir por instinto, como la emoción del enamoramiento que vimos hace un momento, sino que es algo que ya hemos analizado, es un sentimiento. Joven, así que si tú te sientes en algún momento con esos sentimientos de desasosiego, de interpretación de algunos momentos en que tú estás sintiendo que te agobia lo que te está pasando, tenemos una línea telefónica de apoyo emocional. Algunos números donde tú puedes apoyarte son en Chiriquí 774-4428, en Coclé 997-8937, Panamá Oeste 515-7396, entre otros. Thank you very much, teachers.
Thank you. Thanks to you for sharing this important information. And we're going to continue. We're going to start, remember, 12th grade, okay? We're going to start by watching a video, a very important video, in which you can take as an example some tips to take care of when you go grocery shopping, okay, in order to protect yourself and your family. We're going to watch the video right now. Pay attention. Hello, everyone. Today we will learn and practice in English how to protect ourselves and our family against coronavirus when we go grocery shopping. Pay attention to these rules. Once you get home, you take out your shoes and disinfect them with soap or detergent. Take the bags from the supermarket to the laundry room. Wash your hands for about 30 seconds. Take out the mask and put it into the trash can. Take out your clothes and take a shower. Put your clothes into the washing machine with detergent. Wash your clothes. Clean your groceries with water and soap. Sanitize your hands again with water, soap, or alcohol. Then you are ready to share with your family. Thank you for this important video. So you can practice at home. Remember, you can see the steps that we have to take in consideration when we get home after grocery shopping. So let's continue, and we're gonna start talking about the pandemic. New jobs have come up with this thing. Teacher Evelyn, I don't know if you want to send some greetings.
And that's right, yes, I have here some greetings from Angie 8902. Saludos a los estudiantes de Sabanita Verde, Colón.
Hello. Okay, we continue with Panama new jobs needed. Okay, Panama new jobs needed. We're talking about those jobs that are important now, that we need right now. Okay, what is the learning objective of the class? You're going to be able to identify different jobs needed nowadays and also to give information about their duties or responsibilities. Okay. Let's see what are those jobs, okay? The first one, number one, teacher Evelyn will help me with the pronunciation. We got babysitter.
Babysitter.
That person who takes care of your children when you don't have time because you have to work. Number two, personal care assistant.
Personal care assistant.
This person, when we are sick, we need a person who can take care of us, okay? Maybe in the hospital or at home. Number three, personal trainer.
Personal trainer.
Important when we go to the gym, we need a person who can help us to, you know, to train, for training. Number four, nutritionist.
Nutritionist.
We're talking about a doctor who can help us, you know, to stay healthy, okay, with the food and everything, the things that we need to eat, okay? Number five, event planner.
Event planner.
When we want to throw a party or something, we need a person who helps us to organize everything about parties, weddings, or any other kind of party, okay? A home delivery driver.
Home delivery driver.
Oh, I have to be honest here. I like this part because we don't want to go out, and we need a person who can help us with the delivery. Okay, so delivery driver. Number seven, professional home cleaner.
Professional home cleaner.
Person who cleans our houses. Dog walker.
Dog walker.
Person who takes our pets to the park. Social media manager.
Social media manager.
Very important nowadays because these people help us for the promoting services or products.
Yes, the marketing. Mm-hmm.
Personal coach.
Personal coach.
Similar to Spanish, we use a coach here in Panama, okay? This person who can help us to understand how the company works, okay? Let's continue. We got a practice here and we're running out of time. So teacher Evelyn is going to help me with the responses here. Number one, choose the correct profession needed. We got number one. Robert helps me training at the gym. What is that job?
It will be personal trainer.
Personal trainer. Number two, I don't know anything about planning a wedding. I need some help. What person will help me?
Event planner.
Event planner. Number three, you don't have to go out to buy some food. Someone can take it to your home, okay? So we need to call a
home delivery driver.
Home delivery driver, okay? Let's continue with another practice here. We continue sharing information about profession needed, okay? Professions that are needed. Number one, you have to start losing weight. You must go to see a doctor. So you need a
nutritionist.
Number two, Roger is in charge of promoting social media campaigns for the company. So we need a
social media manager.
Number three, I pay Nancy for taking care of my children. This person is
babysitter.
Let's continue here. I don't know if we have some greetings. People joining the class.
Yes, greetings to Pineda, Jennifer, Mayette Cass, Ashfair.
Okay, we will continue and we're going to talk about conjunctions, okay? These are words that help us to connect ideas, para conectar ideas. We got and, lo conocemos, y, but, pero, or, o, okay? Let's see some examples. We have tickets for the symphony and the opera. Tenemos boletos para la sinfónica y para la ópera. The orchestra rehearses on Tuesday, but the chorus rehearses on Wednesday. La orquesta practica los martes, pero el coro practica los miércoles. Have you seen or heard the opera by Scott Joplin? ¿Has visto la o escuchado la ópera? Okay, let's continue. And we're gonna talk about now about verb tenses. Vamos a hablar de los tenses, tiempos, okay? When we talk about in present, past, future, okay? We have to know that there are two types of verb. We got regular verb and we got irregular verb. What is the difference? For example, the verb play, el verbo play, is a regular verb. And the verb drink, it's an irregular verb. What's the difference? Play, when we change the verb to the past, when we use the verb in the past, cuando lo usamos en el pasado, we add ed, agregamos ed. I play, yo juego. I played, yo jugaba. Drink, it's an irregular verb. And what is the difference? The difference is that when we use it in present, I drink, yo bebo. I drink water, yo bebo agua. When we say it in past, the writing changes. La escritura cambia. Drunk. So that is why these are irregular. Okay? We got regular verbs. We got examples here. Play, stop, enjoy, walk. And we got irregular verbs. Take, ride, drink, swim, and others. Okay?
Teacher, we have some greetings here. Saludos para el colegio del IPT Joaquín Herrera de Torrijos y para todos los profesores. Saludos para la profesora Melissa Murillo desde la Escuela Alto Higuerón. Hello, teacher. My name is Celibet Paredes desde Boca del Toro.
Hello.
Saludos para Sofía, que está en sintonía.
Very good. And we're going to continue with the verb tenses, and we got another example here with the verb study, which is a regular verb. In past will be, I studied English. Yo estudiaba inglés. In present, I study English. Yo estudio inglés. Future, I will study English. Estudiaré inglés. Let's see with the verb eat, comer. Okay, it's an irregular verb because the writing changes. Al ser pasado, cambia. Okay, I eat shrimps, como camarones. I ate a hamburger, comí una hamburguesa. Okay, I will eat French fries, comeré papitas, papitas delicious. Fritas, okay? So, these are tenses. There are more tenses. We got progressive when we add ing, cuando agregamos la ing. We got present perfect. Also, when we talk about an action, teacher Evelyn talked about that topic last week. Ella habló de ese tema la semana pasada. When we talk about an action that started in the past and continues in the present, una acción que inició en el pasado y continúa en el presente, present perfect, okay? So, these are tenses that we have. For example, I have eaten shrimps several times. He comido camarones varias veces. So, it is an action from the past to the present, okay? Let's continue, and we got the last practice here, okay, with those two verbs. We got dance and drink, okay? The verb dance is a regular verb. The verb drink, irregular verb, okay? We got number one, we danced all night at Mario's party last Saturday. At Mario's party last Saturday. We're talking in past, so we danced. Because we're talking about last Saturday, pasado. I drink a glass of milk every night before going to bed. Bebo un vaso de leche todas las noches. As it says, every week, so it's present, drink, okay? So, you can continue the practice. We got the assignment. Choose 5 Panama new jobs needed and write about their duties. And the other assignment will be tell us which job you like the most and explain your reason. These are the assignments that you can upload to the Google Plus Classroom platform, teacher Evelyn.
That's right. And I have some message here. Alan, it's an excellent class. Thank you. And also just greetings to Alto Higuero, Melida Castrellón, y Luisa Castrellón.
Remember that you get access to this information. You can go to the platform and you can solve the practices there. We're going to be waiting for your responses, teacher Evelyn.
Yes, so see you next Friday.
Remember, see you, bye-bye.
That you can have all the access, the lessons through our Google Classroom. So please take care.
Bye.
See you.
Síguenos en Instagram, @CrisolFMPanamá. Somos más radio en las redes sociales.
Son las 4.
Nacional FM y Crisol FM te informan.
El Ministerio de Comercio e Industrias advierte que serán sancionadas las personas naturales o jurídicas que utilicen la plataforma de la institución para validar salvoconductos a individuos que no trabajen en sus empresas o no guarden relación con las actividades autorizadas por el Ministerio de Salud. El mal uso del salvoconducto en el estado de emergencia nacional infringe las disposiciones legales y tienen consecuencias. Se hace un llamado a las empresas a estar vigilante en su información. Quienes detecten irregularidades al respecto deben hacer su denuncia al correo denuncias@misi.gob.pa. Si no es necesario salir, quédate en casa.